Well, you guys, today was a great success. My boy Nerry really helped me out. He cut the time in half. I was able to do a lot more than I was originally planned to do. So again, I had the motor installed and I realized the mounts were that bad. So I had pulled it back out, you know, planning to do the mounts. And so I'll just kind of go over with you right now what we did. Well, today, see, we got a lot of shit done. Big thanks to my boy, Nerry. He came through and really helped out. So pulled the motor back out. He helped me remove, he helped me get all this to the point now, but we removed the motor mounts because they were whooped. This was the driver's side, little hanging low, but you can see the passenger side. It was, there's no more bottom on there, and that was hanging so low, that's why I was having issues lining up the dirty dingo. And we took off the liners for the fenders. We took off the coolant bottle battery, got all the harnesses laid out the way, took off this mess, evap canister, we're not using that, the vacuum bottle, the canister, we are going to use that, and he does want cruise control, so we just took all that and put it out to the side, and now we're going to get down to the control arms, because this side was shot. And we're right here about to put a better running engine. So now this is kind of what we're dealing with here. All gummed up, but we're gonna take these off. There goes Nerry on the Honda scooter. Saving gas, kicking ass. Right on, bro. All right, safe. All right. Again, just get back to it with the other hand. Oh, this is rough grime in here. It's already breaking this stuff up. Grab a parts brush that I have out of my parts cleaner. That's also all I use, is concentrated real purple. So I'll just give this a quick little brush down. Sorry guys, because I don't have a camera stand or nothing. So just a little, you can tell this is all gummed up in here. So just give all that rough edges quick little brush. The power washer is going to break most of this grime off, but some of that caked on grime is hard to get off, so just hitting it up with the little brush breaks it up real good, and this degreaser is going to be already in there. Look at that nasty. So I'll just hit it again, let it soak with some fresh degreaser. I for sure had some kind of leakage going on that side. Little quick wipe me down. Little loosey wipe me down. Come around here. Get in those grimy spots. All right, we got the Harbor Freight High Performance Pressure Washer hooked up. Start high. Alright, what's going on, you guys? So just to show you guys what I've done, that little roll did its job. I still have a whole lot left over here. So I have a clean spray gun and everything's taped off that I want to take care of. It's gonna look, I feel pretty decent, and I'll show you guys the looks after. What I'm gonna be using is some paint down from O'Reilly's, jet black cam. All right, so after this rig of liquid courage, make sure you got your pressure. Spray. I'm just gonna do some hard to reach areas. Well, just finished up this. It's a little later and colder than I want it to be as far as spraying, but I got this grandpa's old catalytic heater, and it's actually really warm inside here, this tarp. So I just felt confident and I sprayed this top radiator support. Hit that up in the back as much as I could get to. I finished this up too, the wheel liner, touched that up, and I also hit up the inside of there and the wheel liner on the other side. But I'm gonna let this thing just kind of heat up, this tarp, kind of bake in this paint, and man, this shit came out really nice.